Alright, what's going on, guys? We just got to the gym. I'm about to try out, well, he already tried it, I haven't tried it yet. New Ghost Sonic Cherry Limeade. Packaging sick as fuck, dude. It looks sick. He's already tried it, he says it's bomb.
Yeah.
We got the unflavored, the neutral Ghost.
This size, this creatine basically. We take this pretty much every day, regardless if we're working out or not. We don't cycle off. Only time we cycle off is when we're broken. We can't grab it.
He said it's real good, and this neutral flavor has kind of a weird taste to it. This is unflavored and it's half sodium chloride. Creatine has like a real salty taste. So we're just gonna dome that way we can sip on this by itself so we get the full experience. You said it's real good, so I don't want to mess it up at all. It is easy peel lid. Damn, look at that. Right, for y'all that haven't tried Ghost yet, signature right there. Our scoop always on top. Oh man, it smells good. Yeah.
I don't have cough like that. Just spill some on my shirt.
We don't litter, man.
Hold on, we don't litter. I made a mess.
I'm just gonna shit in my car. Man, I drank too much water. I'm gonna be able to.
That's nasty.
Man.
Sorry. I clean all this for $2.
I
forgot my shaker, I don't know where it's at. So, sorry, excuse me. Cut that out. One scoop, one scoop, quote unquote.
One scoop, that's one scoop.
One rounded scoop. Man, I'm about to make a mess.
Oh, that's stuck my. I'm taking a water, man. Oh, look at you.
What, I made a mess?
No, I almost dropped it.
I think this is my new favorite. Like, better than black cherry.
See. One scoop. Man, who you at? I'm not supposed to. Alright, let's see what this is about, man. First impression, go ahead.
It smells good, too.
Oh, man. Smells good, man. Oh, man.
I wish you guys could smell it, because it smells good, too. Like some
the only thing this is missing is a little fucking cube ice from Sonic.
Yeah, that's why I told. Yeah,
that's all this thing is missing.
So I told Erica, I was like, this like cold.
Oh man.
Or those that crushed ice. It's like a slushy, y'all.
Crushed ice, that's what it is. Crushed ice?
Yeah.
Man,
that's gonna make your lips turn red too.
Yeah, that's good, man. Mine.
Which was this one at?
This. This was my favorite before. Sour green apple. Bomb as fuck, but man, this. Oh man, you guys gotta get this. This is good.
Man. I know you. Now you owe me.
Oh yeah, I still owe you.
You haven't paid me for it.
Fuck that. fuck, that's good. But man, bro, this is good. Y'all should get this, bro.
But yeah, we're just in the gym parking lot. Normally, what we do is just sip on our pre-workout, listen to music, get in the zone, and then we'll head into the gym.
Breakfast.
Whoa. Hello, how are you guys doing?
And you?
Good.
Oh, actually, sorry. Can I have you guys sign in right here?
Oh, the computer went down.
Oh, damn.
I was trying to play, you know, my music, and it was like, no, girl.
Hey, do you know the answer to this?
No cheating? Yeah, there's one right here, and there's one back there, and there's one. Yeah. Do you need a tour or anything?
Oh, this is a guest. My bad. I signed on the guest side. Sign on this side.
Oh, remember?
Hi, how you doing?
You just put it
in.
You're
good.
I can't
read.
Print.
Yeah,
man. Don't judge my guest handle, you know?
You can't see it. Okay.
Alright, what's going on, guys? Doing a little commentary today for our back workout. We started with deadlifts, doing the 3x3. This was our first warm-up set. Our last warm-up set, actually, my bad. Last warm-up set, acclimation set. 365. See how I felt. See what we're going to go with our working weight.
Yeah, Angel's pulling conventional. I'm pulling sumo. That's what I've always pulled. But we're starting our working sets with 405 for 3x3. So we try to go heavy, but we're in a caloric deficit right now, so we're kind of weak. So we only stuck with 405.
And we kind of been, slacking on deadlifts, to be honest.
I haven't deadlifted in a little over a month and a half.
Yeah.
Since February, actually. But I believe this is my last set. I'm shifting my weight really to the right, if you can notice a little bit. It's because my left hamstring is kind of strained a little bit from my last competition. So if you see that, that's what's going on. And plus, I haven't touched deadlifts in a little bit.
Yeah, we did a 3x3. Want to show you guys one set. We don't want to make this video too long, but we did get all our sets, all our reps. He's gonna have to take our word for it. Yeah, after deadlifts, moved on to some Pendlay rows. With these, you want to try to keep your back as flat as possible, as horizontal, and to the floor, and you want to pull towards your chest, not to your stomach or your belly button like a bent over rows. These you want to pull towards your chest, and coming from a dead stop each time. Real good movement, real hard, very humbling. You won't be able to pull as much weight, obviously, if it was strict form, but great back exercise.
Yeah, I hate it. So you'll see me up right here. I need to kind of work on this because I always like shy away from this just because. Who is that?
That's your phone, bitch.
But yeah, we did look around like 10 to 12 sets or reps. Sorry,
yeah. Four sets. 10 to 12 reps, I believe.
I lost count right here, so don't worry about that. Angel's always keeping track of my reps.
Yeah, he'd be trying to cheat.
And then, what did we move on to this after
this? I think
this?
We did a lap pull down.
Yeah.
We're on some lap pull downs. We did four sets, 10 to 12 reps. No, 12 to 15.
Yeah.
12 to 15 reps. These, you want to pull toward your chest still. You want to, keep your scapula retracted. You don't want to, as I did right there, we say, you don't want to let it come undone completely every time. It's just lack of tension that's going to be on there. As you see right here, Victor, you want to lean back a little bit, but you don't want to lean back so far where it becomes a row. It's a vertical pull down. You don't want to lean back so far as to come in a row. If you have to do that, the weight's probably too heavy. And it's a myth, guys. Wide pull-downs do not equal wide lats. You do not need to go crazy wide. You're just going to be hurting yourself in the end. You're going to get a shorter range of motion. You're not going to get a good contraction. It's just, you want a little bit wider than shoulder width. It's perfect. That's all you need.
Yeah, and then we moved on to some low rows. We're using Versa grips, if you see that what's on our wrist. Really good tool to help out with back. So it eliminates as much as biceps as possible. So it really helps to just really focus on pulling with your back. What did we do? Four sets of 10 to 12 again. We're doing really high volume just so we can get a pretty good pump in.
A thing with like straps and versagrip stuff, you want to build up your strength, your grip strength up to a certain point before you start using them. So if you're a beginner and you're just getting into lifting, I would not recommend them. You want to build a good foundation of your grip strength before you start using tools like that. It just comes in handy. Like, it's just a tool, but you still want to be able to have grip strength. You don't want to have to rely on things such as traps or wrist wraps or anything like that. You want to build a good foundation. Same thing with belts. A lot of people ask me about belts. If you're just a beginning lifter, you're just getting into it, I wouldn't recommend it. You need to learn how to brace and how to keep your core tight on your own before you start using a belt. But yeah, after that, we moved on to some unilateral high rows.
Yeah, we could have probably went a little heavier with that. It's kind of a lighter weight, but to be honest, it was kind of burnt out.
Yeah,
I didn't eat all day. Then we moved over to what we call some Hodge Twins wing flies, supersetted with some dumbbell
pullovers.
Yeah. With the dumbbell pullovers, you don't want to go higher than above your face, because then you start activating your chest.
Because the pullovers, they can work your back and your chest, just depending on how far you move and what angle you put your body. So you just want to bring it up to like right above your face, and after that, that's good. Your lat would be activated. After that, you'd just be using more of your chest.
Yeah. But, yeah, we got three sets, 12, 15 reps on each. That was about the whole workout there. We got a pretty good pump. So thanks for you guys for watching. We're about to give you guys a physique update since we're dieting. So we're a little bit over a week in, but appreciate you guys.
Yeah. I'm gonna weigh myself real quick, see where I'm at.
164.2.
This morning I weighed in at 161.6, I think. But we're gonna do a physique update.
Yeah, you better look good, man.
So we just got down with back, so my back's gonna be a little pumped.
Dang, you better looking good, man.
Ah! Oh, man! I'm making fun of my love handles. We're gonna lose that. Give me like.
Where'd you start at? Where'd
I started you start at? 170.4, I think. Around it's the heaviest I've ever been, so I'm not used to looking like this.
Alright, guys, I'm gonna weigh myself too, real quick. See the difference?
He's fully clothed, by the way.
Yeah, shoes. 210. I weighed in this morning at 208 flat. I started around, what was I think, 213? High 212s, 213s, so around there. I do a physique update. We did one on our Instagram already before I started physique, in case y'all ain't following us and see it, which you should be. Just saying. Well, I'll link that down below too. But started physique. It's not the heaviest I've been, but I think the heaviest I've been, I got up to 235, about two, 3 years ago.
About to fly away, man.
I definitely feel like I gained weight from here to around 212. From when I was 234, definitely way more muscle mass, I think. I was a lot, way more just pure fat then. But definitely excited to see my physique this year after I cut. I'm gonna plan to get down to around the low 170s, somewhere around there. Maybe even high 160s, we'll see. But
we'll see. Got a long way to go, man.
See how I feel and how I look. Cause I do plan on competing in the powerlifting meet after this cut, and I want to compete around like the 180, was it the 183, 184?
Yeah,
somewhere around there. That's where I want to compete, so I want to cut down to like low 170s, high 160s, and then build up from there, see how it goes. But yeah, quick little physique update for you guys. About to head home, get some food, and end the video up, so we'll be up tomorrow. Alright, guys, just finished up editing the video right now. Just wanted to record a quick little outro.
Yeah, we forgot to.
But yeah, I just want to thank you guys for watching. Again, I know we said it before, but We appreciate you guys taking time out of your day just to watch us. Please like the video if you guys enjoyed it. Comment down below. Any criticism. We know we still need to work on some stuff. And if you guys want to see it again, please share. Please subscribe if you haven't already. And I think that's about it, man.
Yeah, we just wanted to get a quick outro in since we forgot to do it at the gym. But yeah, just really appreciate any support you guys throw our way.
Yeah, and even support now, like I know like a lot of you guys that know us in person, like know us in real life. Like if you guys watch the video, thanks for the support you guys have given us already. I've had I don't know about you guys, I had a few people myself, like just say, because this has been a goal of ours for a while to start this channel, and we've talked about it before, a lot of people knew. Now they're actually doing it, like getting some support from people that always told us we should. So I just wanted to say thank you guys again. Like, it means a lot. Really appreciate it. And stay tuned for the next one.
Peace out, guys.